Hey guys, so this video, I'm going to take you along with me to Fabulash here in Toronto, and I went to see Brittany to get an eyelash lift. And if you guys don't know what that is, it's basically like a perm for your eyelashes, so it's a great alternative to eyelash extensions, which are quite expensive. They're amazing, but they can range from maybe like $125 to up to $300-$400, depending on the ones that you want. And for someone like myself that has pretty long eyelashes, the lift is a great alternative. It lasts for 2 months. So basically, I'm going to show you in the video how they do it, but the appointment is about 1 hour. And first they apply, they put a barrier around your eyes so nothing gets in your eyes. And they apply a perming solution for about 15 minutes and then a setting solution for another 15. And then you have the option of tinting your lashes as well. So you can get, I believe, black, brown, or blonde. And so you have the option of getting a low, medium, and high lift. The one that I got was the high lift, which I've never done before. Usually I get the medium, and I would definitely recommend the high lift just if you want the most impact. I feel like it really opens up my eyes. Even my boyfriend, who would not really notice something like that, he said like when he noticed when I was sleeping, like my eyelashes just looked prettier. And I think it really, I don't know, it makes your eyes look a lot brighter. It almost looks like I have, without any makeup on at all, like the most basic set of eyelash extensions. So because you know, guys know, I have my eyebrows microbladed, and now with the lash lift, you can pretty much, like if you need to go to the gym or if you don't really need to get dressed up for work, you can pretty much just go if you have those two things done, in my opinion. But anyway, I will take you along. I'll show you everything. If you guys have any questions, let me know. If you live in Toronto, hit up Brittany at Fabulash. Their location's on King West, so if you live downtown, it's really easy to get to. And I believe they're open late and most weekends, so if you work kind of like the normal 9-to-5 hours, they're very accommodating. And just keep in mind, this video is not sponsored at all. I'm not even monetizing it. I just really, really like Brittany, and I went there for eyelash extensions before. I think she does a great job, and it's just kind of interesting to see how she achieved this result if you're interested in doing it in your own hometown if you don't live in Toronto. And yeah, so follow me along. Thanks for watching, guys, and please subscribe if you're not.
I thought I'd show you guys the aftercare. So it's pretty similar to the eyelash extension aftercare. So you have to keep the lashes dry for 24 hours. So avoid steam rooms, or if you haven't worked out, make sure if you are, maybe not to be sweating too much. Do not sleep with your lashes pressed in the pillow for the first 5 to 10 days, so try to sleep on your back. Best to avoid waterproof mascara and oil-based makeup. I've never really followed that rule, and my lash lifts have still lasted over 2 months, but if this is your first time, I would definitely follow that rule. And yeah, you can repeat the lash lift after 4 weeks, but in my opinion, I think my lash lift has always lasted 2 to 2.5 months. And I'll also just show you guys the prices here. So there you go, lash lift $75, the tint $25, but if you combine it, it's only $90. And then if you compare that to the volume sets of eyelash extensions over here, it's quite a big difference. So definitely try this if you never have.
Alright, I'm ready now, I ain't gonna fall back down, no. Alright, I'm taking on me, baby. All I ever ask, are you gonna be my lover? Tonight, I take you with me.
But if I left, then it made no sense. And you tell your friends and they hold your hands. Baby, never mind.
Choose the curl of the lashes. How many options are there?
There's small, medium, and large.
Okay.
Small is for most of the lashes, but your lashes will be fine. curled. Some people kind of like it being like more subtle. It's too much for me. They just want like a little tiny curl.
Mm-hmm.
That'd be like a medium. Or if someone has extremely long lashes, I'd probably do a large on them.
Say you had this done, are you able to get extensions, like say in a couple weeks, or are your lashes too curly?
They're way too curly. No point of adding extensions because they're already going to look good already, especially with your lashes. People offer it all the time, and they always want to get extensions and then a lift, or a lift and then extensions, but it's either or. You have to keep them dry for 24 hours. And then no saunas, no steam rooms. If you are going to the gym today, no crazy sweating, like no water cardio. No oil-based products for cleaning. No waterproof mascara. It's pretty simple maintenance. Like by tomorrow, you can just wash your face how you usually do. You can rub your eyes. The curl will still stay. So in the first 24 hours, you have to be super careful.
Now I'm just going to move everything with a Q-tip. And we're going to do the same thing with the starting motion.
Brush them out.
Okay.